what I wanted to try to get at was, to me, given the mosaic of businesses you have, there's just always a lot of things that are working. I mean, I thought it was interesting, not non-residential, okay, but warehouse, data center good, housing good, and a lot of the different states are using this moment to do a lot of road work.
Jim, that's exactly right. And what we saw during the quarter, to your point, we actually turned in, you'll love this, Jim, it was the safest half year we've ever had in our company's history. It was the most profitable half year we've ever had in our company's history. And what we see with safety is we see production efficiencies, we see lower SG&A, we actually had lower fuel costs. But to your point, housing behaved very well in the quarter. We think housing is going to continue to behave very well. Infrastructure was solid. And part of what we're seeing, Jim, is gasoline taxes have come back to within 6% of where they were pre-COVID. So things have recovered much more quickly in that dimension. And now we're watching some of the things that you are too. What's going to happen with phase four stimulus and some things that could actually put some important healing notions to some of the public side of construction right now. But I have to tell you, I was incredibly proud of our team and the performance they put in the second quarter and first half.
Well, there are states out there that you dominate and that sound like there's so much good that's happening that I was worried about. North Carolina. I mean, that is just a place where a lot of business is being done.
Well, it is. And a lot of people are moving to North Carolina. The population trends are enormous. And here's a big change that we saw in that state. When we were talking in Q1, we were anticipating probably $600 million worth of bidding activity in FY21, which has just begun. And now North Carolina DOT has estimated they're going to have about $1.3 billion worth of lighting. So North Carolina is an important state for us, but so is Colorado. And Colorado is issuing significant bonds in that state so they can continue construction up and down the I-25 corridor, which is home to well over 80% of the population there. But what's important, too, are states like Texas. That's our largest state by revenue. They've got a lending schedule of $7.1 billion for the fiscal year that's going to start on September 1, very much in line with where they were in the previous year. And keep in mind, Jim, they've got a nearly $10 billion rainy day fund that right now it looks like they might not even have to tap. So where you are in this business, the states in which you choose to do business and the MSAs within those states in which you locate really drives the success of a business like ours.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.